Hello, everybody. My name's Ian McMillan, and I'm your host for the whole Choral Union virtual spring concert. We're all virtual today, but the great thing about music is that it does bring us all together. And what I'm excited about tonight is that the songs are that perfect meeting of language and music. Somehow, language and music meet together and create something that's bigger than the sum of the parts, that thing that we call song, particularly song sung by a choir. So I'm going to be introducing each section, perhaps reading a poem and also talking about the words that are used in the songs. Our first two songs are The Amaryllis Dance in Green by Bird and The Silver Swan by Gibbons. The Silver Swan, the words are by that well-known poet Anonymous, but gosh, what words. Let me just read this bit. The Silver Swan, who living had no note, when death approached, unlocked her silent throat, leaning her breast against the reedy shore, thus sang her first and last, and sang no more. Those are exquisite words. I love that phrase, reedy shore. Absolutely beautiful. And the way the choir sing it will illuminate those words, like choirs always do. I'm going to read a little poem that maybe isn't as profound as the one we just heard. It's about the fact that I like to sing when I'm doing the washing up. And that reminds me of my dad, who always sang when he was doing the washing up. He would be there in his floral pinny and he would sing. His thin, reedy tenor would echo around the kitchen. And this is a song, this is a poem about me, and I'm putting my pinny on. And it's about the fact that when you get older, you do get a bit forgetful. So this is called Old Age. Old age is simply this. Put a pinny on to do the pots, then forget. And put another pinny on to do the pots. Pinny on pinny. Two pinny morning. Pinny pinny fastened at the back. A pinny on a pinny. A double pinny moment. And the pots not done. And the idea of that is that I just forget. I forgot that I put two pinnies on. But you know, it didn't matter. I just kept the two pinnies on. And I carried on singing, because that's the thing about singing. You can do it anywhere. You can listen to it anywhere. So let's listen to a song.
Though Amaryllis dance in green,
though Amaryllis dance in green,
we'll be right back.
The great thing about songs is that they can be part of the past, part of the present, and part of the future. Our concert, our virtual concert, is taking us chronologically. Songs from the past, songs from the present, songs glancing at the future. But the great thing about songs is that they are time machines. You can hear a song from the 15th century and it takes you back to the 15th century, but also you're hearing it now in whole in 2021 and it speaks to you and it suggests a possible future where words and music can meet in the most profound way. When we can all meet together again, the songs will bring us together in such a great way. We've got three songs in this section. April Is In My Mistress' Face by Morley. Fair Phyllis by Farmer, and another Morley one, Now Is the Month of May. And the words again, the simplicity and the profundity of these words. April is in my mistress's face, and July in her eyes hath place. Within her bosom is September, but in her heart a cold December. You could say, well, we've all met people like that in one way, where the year reflects somehow in their soul, but I just love the cleverness of that, the metaphor of it, the simile of it, the simplicity and profundity of it, which is there on the one hand, which is then given even more weight by the way the choir sing it. Fabulous, fabulous song. Of course, we've all suffered this last year through the lockdown. And when the lockdown first started, I was asked by Barnsley Museums to be their poet in lockdown. A lot of people said I should have been locked up, but they said, could you be our poet in lockdown? And I wrote sonnets, because I like sonnet. A sonnet is a very musical form. It means little song in Italian, obviously. And this is just a sonnet that I wrote on day 30 of the lockdown, almost a year ago, 21st of April, 2020. And it's just about the idea of being stuck inside, which we all were. This lockdown seals up people face to face. No garden to charge in and let off steam. The walls are squeezing close. You feel the space is getting tighter. Now you want to scream. It's like we're in the middle of a dream, a nightmare built on fear and whispered news. The flat upstairs sounds like a football team is taking shots at goal. I wish they'd lose. Outside, the sky has really got the blues. We are stuck inside. The sunlight slaps the floor. This lockdown's not the life we thought we'd choose. A turning key, a click, a solid door. Stand here, you lot. I'll take a photograph, but one day we'll all look at it and laugh. And I was trying to imagine, I'm lucky because I've got a garden, trying to imagine being in a flat with no garden and just gathering the people together and taking a photo. And you'd hope that in those situations, song will help us through. Let's have some songs.
Oh,
Thank you for being with us at the Whole Choral Union Virtual Spring Concert. And none of us can wait until we can all be together in the same room, singing, enlivening the air. We're moving forward chronologically now. Here's three songs, one by Elgar, one by Bambi, one by Stamford. As Torrents by Elgar, Sweet and Low by Bambi, and Quick, We Have But a Second by Stamford. Elgar is one of my favourite composers. Somehow within him, he distills, I don't know, the sense of what Englishness is, the sense of what it is to stand there in awe and feel the wind blowing into your face. Somehow that wind blows, I know Elgar's not from awe, but somehow that wind blows with a kind of Elgar tint to it. I don't know, he understood what being English and being British was all about. The Song of Elgar's has got words by Longfellow. Now, Longfellow is kind of half forgotten these days. We don't talk much about Longfellow as a poet. But what Longfellow is great at is doing that thing that it's good to set poems as. In other words, sometimes the poet does too much. I've done it myself when I've written words for songs. You do too much. With Longfellow, he does just enough and he leaves space. It's as though he knows that his songs are going to be set by great composers. So the As Torrents begins. As torrents in summer, half dried in their channels, suddenly rise, though the sky is still cloudless, for rain has been falling far off at their fountains. What a fantastic opening to a song, because it gives the music room to breathe. It gives the choir chance to take flight. As torrents in summer, half dried in their channels. Loads of vowels and consonants just bumping against each other gently there in a very exciting way. Do enjoy these songs. And I'm just going to read you a poem of mine. Now this one, I'm lucky in that I get asked to write poems. I've been asked to write a new poem for today. And somebody rang me up and they said, look, we'd like to write a poem about maths for a new maths book. I said, all right, what kind of maths? They said, that kind of maths where you go shopping and you haven't got a list, so you forget to buy the bread. I said, oh yeah, that maths. They said, can the poem be 20 lines long, rhyme A, B, A, B, and start and finish with the same line? I thought, yes, that's a musical idea. I could see me doing that and it being set to music. And he said, could you give an example of what you might eat if you've got no bread? And I said, yes, boiled egg with deserters. He didn't get it either, but I thought I'll put that in the poem. And I sent the poem off and he said, I quite like lines 6 and 7, but not in that order. And that taught me that as a poet, as a musician, your first idea maybe isn't your best idea and you should always have a go at rewriting and rewriting and rewriting. So this poem got rewritten a lot and I still can't fathom what it's got to do with maths. But anyway, it's called No Bread. I wish I'd made a list. I forgot to get the bread. If I forget it again, I'll be dead. We had blank and butter pudding, beans on zip, boiled egg with deserters, no chip butty, just chip. I wish I'd made a list. I forgot to get the bread. My mum got the empty bread bin and wrapped it round my head. Our jam sarnies are just jam floating on the air. We spread butter on the table because the bread wasn't there. My mum says if I run away, she knows I won't be missed. Not like the bread was. I wish I'd made a list. I wonder what Elgar would have made of that.
Suddenly rise, for the sky.
Quick, we have but a second fill. Well, the cup are you made for time. The churl hath beckoned, and we must away, away.
But the pleasures that vanish
the whole, not all his frame could gaze. He cannot
arrive
for charm to life again. Hey, quick, we have but a second fill. Round the cup are you made for time. The churl hath beckoned, and we must away, away. How it flushes like some young thief is lit, and half his time and blushes that catches the lane to sip. Shame, 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 if e'er thou seest that day break up the wind, and turn a touched away. Then quick, we have but a second, fill round the cup while you may, for time the child hath beckoned, and we must away, away.
We are moving towards the present day now, with three songs. First one, To Daffodils, by Dominic Wright, member of the choir, and The Lamb, by Lawrence Rugg, and Laughing Song, by Lawrence Rugg. Dominic has set the wonderful Robert Herrick, who is a fantastic poet. And again, what Herrick does, which is good for a song setter, is he knows where the vowels and consonants should go to make it not easy to set, but exciting to set. I've written song lyrics in the past where people have said, look, you can't have that vowel bumping in to that consonant. You've got too many B's and P's together. It takes a lot of learning. Herrick just knows how to do it. I mean, these first couple of lines, fair daffodils, we weep to see you haste away so soon, as yet the early rising sun has not attained his noon. Gosh, the way that flows must be a gift, an absolute gift to a composer. This last couple of years, I've been working a lot with composers, and they're all different. I wrote a big piece for choirs in Hertfordshire with Anne Dudley, fantastic composer who writes a lot of television music. And she would, I'd send the words, you normally start with the words, I'd send the words, she would rewrite, I'd rewrite, I'd go down to her house. There was a disconcerting bit, I've got to tell you, where she would write the words, sing the songs with the words I'd written. She'd then do some la-la-la with words that she wanted. And then she'd stop and stare at me with her hands just over the piano, as though I was meant to come up with the words there and then, which I almost did. I then wrote a piece with the fantastic composer Jonathan Dove, who is a great composer for choirs. But he said the way we should write together was that we should walk around a lot. And so we met in London when we could meet and walked around Victoria Park for hours. And I kept coming up with ideas because I thought I'd better think of something. But in the end, we just walked about and talked. And after three of these walking and talking sessions, he said, I now understand, Ian, how you speak, how you think, how your rhythms of your speech go. And then we had the idea, and then we wrote it. So working with composers is such a joy, and they're all different, and they all take your words and work with them in a different way. And I'm very excited to be reading a brand new poem today, which I think is partly about my dad, because my dad was a sailor. My dad loved the sea. He was at sea for 20-odd years in the Royal Navy, and he would sing. And I always pictured him singing on the ship because he sang all the time when he came home. And the idea that somehow in a town like Hull, the sea is there all the time. You know, the sea is a constant. The sea is a constant over your shoulder all the time, or in the distance, or right next to you. And I imagined the idea of a choir being somehow as old as the sea. Somehow, you know, and just so it's called Waves of Song. And I've written it deliberately about these times, but also thinking that maybe one day this could be set to music with alterations, of course. And maybe one day when we can all get together, we can sing this. So it's called Waves of Song. Hear our voices rising like tide does, moving like water moves on waves of song. Hear our voices, melodic weather flowing over the city. Pure and strong. Hear our voices, old as history, new as tomorrow, and flying high. Hear our voices, all embracing, a long procession across the sky. At times like these, when we can't be together, singing stands so very close, you can hear it breathe, and it holds your hand, and the mask falls away, the notes are glowing. And I believe that a choir can transport us like a boat can carry us safely across the sea to somewhere bright where hope is growing. And that's the place I'd like to be. Hear our voices, northern voices, singing in the evening air. Hear our voices like a sunrise, lighting up time everywhere. And that last couple of lines were kind of a gift. I wrote them and I was thought about lighting up time. Then the idea of a song lighting up time, because that's what I think they do. The songs that we're hearing today, they light up time somehow. Somehow a song can last 5 minutes, but it feels like it's lasted no time at all, or it's lasted for years. So I do hope you're enjoying this concert, and let's hear these final songs.
Yeah.
When the greenwood's laugh with the voice of joy,
when the greenwood's laugh with the voice of joy, and the dimpling stream runs laughing by, when the air does laugh with a merry wit, and the green hill laughs with the voice of it.
When the meadows laugh with lively green,
and the grasshopper laughs in the merry scene,
when Mary and Susan and Emily with their sweet round mouths sing ha ha he.
When the painted birds laugh in the shade,
when the painted birds laugh in the shade,
where the table with cherries and nuts is spread,
come, may you have been merry and join with me
to sing the sweet chorus of
ha, ha, ha,
ha, ha, ha, ha, ha, ha, ha, ha,
ha.
Well, thank you very much, everybody, for coming along to the whole Choral Union spring concert that's been virtual. Hope you've enjoyed the music and the words. And let's look forward to a time when we can all get together in the same room, standing quite close, sharing the sound of wonderful singing. So hope you've enjoyed the concert, but it's a taster of what's to come. See you all soon.
When the greenwood's laugh with the voice of joy,
when the greenwood's laugh with the voice of joy,
and the dimpling stream runs laughing by,
when the air does laugh with a merry wit,
and the green hill laughs with the voice of it.
When the meadows laugh with lively green,
when the meadows laugh with lively green,
and the grasshopper laughs in the merry scene,
when Mary and Susan and Emily with their sweet round mouths sing ha ha he.
When the painted birds laugh in the shade,
when the painted birds laugh in the shade,
where the table with cherries and nuts is spread,
come, may you have been merry and join with me
to sing the sweet chorus of
ha.